We are in Ohio on my way out to Craftsbury.
The Craftsbury Outdoor Center is located in northeastern Vermont, and it's the host of this fall's US Biathlon Training Camp, our only training camp that we've been able to have so far due to COVID.
First morning here, beautiful Craftsbury, but I got 7 days of just hanging out in this cabin all by myself. Well, it's now been a week since I've been in quarantine here in Craftsbury. Get to go get my tests today, and then hopefully results come back relatively soon. And then I can hang out with the rest of my team instead of by myself in this cabin. COVID testing. All right. Take down my mask?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, face this way. Sorry.
All right,
have a good day.
All right, thanks. I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, I think she tickled my brain. Oh my gosh. All right, now we just gotta wait for the test results. Morning. October 9th here, first day of the team camp. Thankfully, my test results came back yesterday, and I am COVID negative, but positive for attitudes. So I get to rejoin my team in training now. So yeah, team camp starts now, baby. Bam, 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 bam.
I'm gonna go get my water.
Wednesday, October 14th. Tomorrow, we have our first of two time trials here in Craftsbury. So, head into the weight room, do a little strength. I like to do strength before our intensities now. Wakes the body up a bit. So, go in there, throw around some weight, and then rest and race tomorrow. Hold up, but we still eat outside because we'd rather eat together than alone, right?
Yes.
One team, one dream. No, she won't.
Oh, that was gorgeous.
Morning of the first time trial here in Craftsbury. I think there's 10 guys, which, I mean, by normal standards is not a lot, but for COVID standards, it's good. So hopefully ski fast, shoe clean today. That's the goal.
Dude, back into race timing where it's like, well, now we just have like 50 minutes.
My misfortune today was on my ski. My ski broke after prone. Too much weight room. Even though my ski broke, my spirit did not. And I will rise again.
Been in the weight room and you still have done too much weight.
Hey man, starts now.
Second day of time trials here in Craftsbury.
Much different day. It's kind of cold, kind of rainy. Short individual, so four shootings, 12.5K of racing. Should be good.
What's the plan today?
Try to dry out these trails with our ski.
Pit stops are going to be important today.
Yeah.
Hopefully not for me like yesterday. Over. Skied well, but was real close to a good one. Shooting was 0-0-0-3. So, one shooting away from a good one. Now it's time to get dry. Hopefully a good situation to be in, coming in last shooting clean, and then try and make it work. But, oh well. Next time. After the races, it was a bit like calm after the storm, waiting to hear from US Biathlon after we had duked it out on the ski course. Some people were wondering if they would head over to Europe right away or have to wait until January for their chance to go race. How do you feel this team naming will affect your season as a whole?
It's a deep question.
Oh God. I guess, I don't know. If things go well and I get named to the World Cup, then I'd be really excited because then I'd be racing a longer season.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, it's significant just because there's so much uncertainty this year.
Approaching this year just as a training year as a whole, just because it seems like the season is still a question mark.
It's good regardless because then I just get more training time in the US and get to spend more time with my family and friends before racing over in January.
But we'll see what happens.
Even though I knew I was heading to Europe after the conclusion of the races, the questions surrounding COVID and what this season would look like were still at the front of my mind. Fly over on October 31st, which gives me only 1 week at home after this Craftsbury camp to be at home before leaving for 5 months, because I don't think we're gonna be able to come home for Christmas due to COVID. And I don't think family members are gonna be able to come over and visit us because we're gonna be in this like athlete bubble. It's definitely the less glamorous side of biathlon. It's like just so hard to be away from your life for so long, and just it's just like a lot of like thoughts, and I just think like the reality of this season, it's like it's gonna be so different than every other year, and like I think there's a lot of athletes that may feel like they're getting themselves into something that they maybe didn't sign up for. How?
You know, it's been hard on my wife too. She understands that I want to be there for her.